أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، أعظم إنجاز يمكن أن تحققه في هذه الدنيا هو أن يحبك الله سبحانه وتعالى. The biggest accomplishment that anyone can accomplish in this life is to achieve the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an objective that every believer should work for. Abu Darda radiyallahu anhu قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يدعو بدعاء داود عليه السلام: اللهم إني أسألك حبك وحب من يحبك والعمل الذي يبلغني حبك، اللهم اجعل حبك أحب إلي من نفسي وأهلي ومن الماء البارد. This is part of a dua that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make, which is Prophet Dawood alayhi salam used to make in reference to asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain his love. Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak, O Allah, I ask you to grant me your love. Naturally, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not given to anyone. It's not something that he just pick and choose and gives his love to. كذلك, when you ask, O Allah, grant me your love, it's like, who is here doesn't love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ask anyone, they will tell you we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the love that we are looking for, Allah, أو العمل الموجب لمحبة الله سبحانه وتعالى, يعني الحب الحقيقي الذي يوصلك إلى حب الله سبحانه وتعالى, هذا هو الهدف الأسمى. So you want the real love that leads you to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not important that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as important as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you. يعني ممكن انت تحب شخص وهو ما بيحبك, وممكن انت ما تحب شخص وهو بيحبك. You may love someone and he doesn't like you, and you may dislike someone and he likes you. So you may say I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't love you. Why? Because you're not doing what you're supposed to do to love him. He told you how to love him. So let's keep looking at the hadith. Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak wa hubba man yuhibbuk. Not only to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to grant you, make you love him, but also to love those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, or whom who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He may love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for some reason or another, I don't like him. But I know he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then I need to love him for that, because I claim the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, I should love everyone who loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah, make me love those people who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of my feelings. That's a dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak wa hubba man yuhibbuk wal amal alladhi yuballighuni hubbak. Now I am begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show me what he likes, so I can do it and reach the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah, how do I know? Well, this is like saying, O Allah, make me love seeking knowledge. Because with knowledge, you would know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what He likes, and you do it. And based on that, you would love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know His names and attributes, you know His ni'am, you know how and what He has given you, and everything is from Him. This should lead you to loving Him for the ni'am that He subhanahu wa ta'ala given you. This is naturally every human being. If you know someone is doing so much good for you, you would love him. So it could be like saying, "Oh Allah, absirni bihadihi ni'am al-zahira wa ni'am al-batina hatta uhibbak." Oh Allah, make me see the ni'am, or remember the ni'am, the one that I see and the one that I don't see. There are so many things that you should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for and you don't see it. It's inside of you. It's things that you don't even know. But it may come to you at some time and you go, "Wow, mashallah, this is a ni'mah I never thought about." So all of this would lead to that. Allahumma ij'al hubbaka ahabba ilayya min nafsi. O Allah, make your love more beloved to me than myself.